Amen. First of all, I want to welcome you to our Friday Bible study. We pray, as always, the Lord has been really good to you this past few days. We're looking forward to the Lord doing even greater things for us as the time draws near for His to remove His church from this planet, which is known as the rapture of the church. In the meanwhile, we're going to be busily doing all we can in order to reach as many souls as we can with the gospel of Jesus Christ. I'm James Langston, and this is the Pilgrim Outreach Ministries, as most, if not all of you know, and we welcome you. We don't say that perfunctorily, but we truly mean that we welcome you, and we're just thankful that you have joined us for our Bible study. We pray that we will say something that will help you to understand this great book of Zechariah, which we're studying, the sixth chapter. We're going to pick up in verse 6. We pray that by the end of this study, we will have said something to help you understand the Word of God a little better, and also will give you a greater hunger for the things of God. Let's go to the Lord in prayer before we begin our tonight's study, and believe God for great things to come. Precious Lamb of God, how we thank you and praise you that you have been good to us in spite of what we have done and how we have acted. We're asking that you will bless us tonight as we endeavor to study your word. We pray that the teacher, the Holy Spirit, will show up and help us to understand your word, to rightly divide the word of truth. Bless us, O Lord, in our rising up and our going forth, and help us to stand on your word and believe you for great things. Father, we just believe you that the word of God is going to go forth. It's going to be like manna from on high. Bless us and encourage us, teach us, touch us, and move upon us. In the mighty and the holy name of Jesus Christ, we ask it. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. We're going to pick up in verse 6 of chapter 6 of this book of Zechariah, and see what the Lord has for us this night. Praise the Lord. It said, the black horses which are therein go forth into the north country, and the white go forth after them, and the gristle go forth toward the south country. Spouse note says, if one is to notice, the red horses are not mentioned here, possibly because they were not in function at that time due to the absence of war, and red symbolizing war. The phrase, the black horses which are there and go forth into the north country, refers to north of Israel, as this land is always the focal point. All of this has to do with the situation of the world during Zechariah's day, concerning the overthrow of the Babylonian Empire and the rise of the Medo-Persians. Men thought they were running the show, but we are told here that the Lord was guiding it all, and God's hand is guiding the affairs of this world. And the questions have been asked throughout the ages is, why doesn't God put a stop to all of the wars and all of the murders and all of the crimes that are occurring? Why doesn't you ever wonder that? Why doesn't God just step in and shut it down? Free will. Man has free will. Man can choose to follow the ways of God, or man can reject that. You see, a lot of times we as Christians, we try to take the halfway road. You know, not too much, not too little, just kind of in the middle. Where the world, huh? Yeah, where the world will like me, and you know, the church will like me as well. But as a child of God, you can't straddle the fence. Hallelujah. It's a very uncomfortable feeling to fold on a picket fence while you are straddled. Hallelujah. Get the drift. Glory to God. Don't do that when serving the Lord. The pointy end. That's what I was talking about. Spraddle. You know what spraddle is? Ever heard of it? Spraddle. Straddle. Spraddle. Praise the Lord. Spraddle. You didn't pick it up, so, you know, you that country didn't pop out real quick. But anyway, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That's hope. Don't despair. Verse 7. And the bay went forth and sought to go, that they might walk to and fro through the earth. And he said, get you hence, walk to and from through the earth. So they walked to and fro through the earth. And before I read the expositor's notes, I was talking with Chris. He got a copy of this. And he told me on Wednesday night, he said he really enjoys reading. He said, of course, he can't be here, as you know, because of his attending classes on Friday. But he said he really enjoys you know, the understanding that he that is given from the commentary notes, the expository notes from the verses themselves. He said it was really a great help, you know, for him and his wife to be able to read the verses and to also have the understanding. Praise the Lord. You know, we need understanding when we're reading the Word of God. There's nothing more bland than just reading words on a paper. Now, you want to have some understanding behind this. You want to know. And the Lord has opened up so many doorways for us to know what is actually is going on so that we will know what the promises of God are in His Word and how they apply to us. It is so easy. It's just a click away to know what the Word of God says. Get on the computer, click the keyboard, praise the Lord, and you can become a theologian overnight. Praise the Lord. Father Noah says, the thrice repeated phrase, walk to and fro, heightens the sense of the wholehearted energy of these mighty executors of divine justice. All of this represents judgment upon the earth in Zerubbabel's time. Many who do not understand God or His ways consider these actions as cruel, especially when the judgment is severe. How dare anyone label God as being cruel? And we always, I should say we always, but you hear how men try to shift blame on God. You know, it was, he could have done something, and he did do something on Calvary. He did it all. But if we don't accept what he did for us at the cross, then we have no one to blame but ourselves. Not my brother, not my sister, but it's me, oh Lord. Me, standing in the need of prayer. Why is God many times the last person called on? After we tried this, after we tried that, after this didn't work, after that scheme didn't work, all of a sudden it's, Lord, can you help me? Huh? Yeah, pride, but a lot of times it's just ignorance and stupidity on our part. We just don't believe that God can do it. It really boils down to that. But if God say He can do, God say I can do anything. I mean, there's nothing that God cannot do. Nothing. It's us that bite our nails and we get so, you know, caught up in things and so worried about situations that we have no control over at all. And then it's, oh Lord, I don't. God said I can do anything. He said, be it unto you according to your faith. If you can believe me and it's in my will, I will do it. Plain and simple. Hallelujah. You know, a lot of it has to do with our lack of walking in faith. We are people that walk by sight. And then when faith is required, we don't know how to act because we have not walked in faith. We've walked by sight. I know how to do it. I know where to go. But now it's, you're in the middle of the ocean on a little rowboat and it has holes in it and you're going down. And nobody around to help you but God. Now you got to have some faith. And now you're struggling because you've never had to really produce faith before. Faith is just that. You have nothing to do with it. It's all God. Hallelujah. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Faith. 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 Simply believing that an all-eternal, all-powerful God can do anything. That's all it's about. And God wants to bring us to the place where we stop worrying about all of the particulars of all the details and just say, Lord, it's yours to work out. Praise the Lord. Something been running across my spirit before I finished the spousal note. And I was asking the Lord, should I say it or not? And he didn't say nothing, so I kind of think that he does. That he will allow me to do so. This is one of the hardest things for us to be faithful to. When I say us, I'm talking about you by the internet too. Okay? Praise the Lord. That number right there. What does that pertain to? As we know it. A tenth. Tithing, praise the Lord, a tenth. Tithing, hallelujah. That is hard for us to do. Oh, glory to God. You know, if you make, let's say, your salary is $400 a month, What's a tenth of that? 40. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Now you still have $360 that you can use for you. Praise the Lord.